I paint people in situations, mainly women, because they're rounder. They're empowered. You know, they've reached the top of their form. They're enjoying life. They're enjoying where they are in the world. They've kind of gotten a little beat up to get there. They're sexy, warm, generous creatures. They're people I know, my daughters-in-law, my mom, my friends, and all of the little women up inside me that jump up and down and, you know, want to come out and play, they come out in these paintings. I like relationships, situations with people where you see a woman with a child, men and women, the way they interact. Just everything you do feeds that. And sometimes it's just like little things are getting filed away in your head. And sometimes it kind of puts itself together at night. You can kind of dream about it and things you've seen. You go, yeah, this would be great. We will take this person in this situation and put them in this kind of a background. And yeah. And then sometimes after you get started with that idea that you had to begin with, it goes someplace else. So, and then the third part of that is to try not to kill it. Because if you overpaint it, for me, it just kind of deadens it and it gets flat. So you've got to stop before you kill it. This is painted on board. It's MDF. It's a wonderful substance for me to work on because it's totally smooth and it's lightweight if you get the thinner board, which these are, which they have to be framed. And all of this area of her skin, her face, is typical of how I paint, which is with dry pastels, varnished, and then acrylics for big color blocks. And then sometimes oil sticks for a little extra slicky, gooey look to it. So hence the mixed media. Sometimes I put paper in there, but for these, I wanted them really, really smooth, so I left the paper out. This area, which on all of the women, I have kept the section of the hair has nothing on it. This is just what MDF looks like without anything on it. If you varnish it, it gets a little bit, it changes color. So this has nothing. I have done a few things. I thought, oh, these things will really sell. Nah, they didn't. It's these wild ones like, God, who in the world would want this? But I had fun doing it. And they're the ones that go. So there have been times when somebody has come up to me and go, okay, I'll take this one. And I'm like, that one? You want that one? And
that's probably why they
bought it. It probably is. You know, you're always, you buy into somebody else's creativity or their energy or their fun or their mood because it reflects either what you feel inside or what you're needing. So maybe that's it. Music's real important in our family, and I think most people it is. It's just, we love music. It helps me paint. I usually blast music while I'm painting to kind of get in some kind of a groove. I did an enormous painting. For me, it was a 40 by 50, and it was this woman holding a baby, and I called it The Decision. And, she had decided to keep the baby, and it changed her life forever is what the little, title went with it. And I had done it just before an exhibit I was to do at Texas A&M in College Station, and my husband said, are you sure you're ready to put that out there? Because it was extremely personal. And I said, yeah, I really was. So I think it depends on who you are. If you're a very introverted, private person, maybe there'll be some paintings that won't go out, but I hardly have a secret in my head. I think if somebody asked me, some aspiring artist, somebody trying to get started, what do they do first? Or what all do they need to do? What's expected of them? What's this world like? I would say you've got to wear a lot of hats and be willing to wear them. There's times you've got to get over into your more organized side, your business side. It depends on what your goals are. If you're wanting to sell your work, you do have to be rather business-minded at times. But if you're just painting for yourself, God, go for it, and lucky you.